again, just a few seconds, and so if I go back to so we have e-spiritual, and then we come to exporting, which is the title is very explanatory actually. So it's called A Piano Piece for a Guitar Player. And this is the milestone of my whole research. In this research consisted mainly of composing, I mean, and documenting all the compositional processes, like 15 compositions, I think, more or less. And then on top of this, I shared these compositions with different musicians all around, anyone who I consider was kind of doing something very similar to instrumental techniques in interchange, even with naming these differently. So what I did was like 30 interviews to international musicians all over, and I organized a concert in Salzburg with Cygnus Ensemble from New York, Neo Percussion from Spain, a lot of musicians so all around, and documenting and trying to find out what is happening now, comparing me to the discourse since Claude Debussy, and from this moment, trying to think what consequences are happening right now after this research with people involved, and what I think it could happen, actually. So this is my result, my research. And a piano piece, normally, because I'm mainly an artist, and I love to produce, I love to create, and I used to say, I don't say this anymore, that I used to two hands. One hand is the scientific part, in this case is the instrumental techniques interchange, but actually I need to compensate this with the artistic part. And very often it's like the message you need to communicate, or the storytelling you need to communicate. And so in this one, you're gonna see it's very clear, I was not aware of that this piece would be so important for me, and it would be the milestone of my research. But when I recorded this, when Elisa Villa recorded this, a guitar player who's gonna play on a piano, we did this introduction with this other part, and it's very easy to understand.
What I wanted to show in the piece,
it's me, 12 years ago,
was a guitarist who wakes up one morning and she starts practicing, doing her scales, arpeggios, repertoire, and so. And then we see her and we might think that she's blind, actually, because she doesn't see the difference between a guitar and a piano. But she might think that we are the blind ones because we are not able.
She never played piano in her life before. Claude Debussy had an obsession with the guitar, and he used the quotation quasi guitarra in the ninth prelude for piano, and also in Iberia for the string section. And so, kind of, today I realized that he was also obsessed with the tuning of the fourth of the guitar, and this piece means an instrumentalist is exposing her techniques to an external instrument. And also this other piece, Hommage à Trois, is an homage to the string trio, but sometimes I've complained, or I made jokes very often about when you put four instruments, two violins, one viola, and one cello, and you call it string quartet in English. Of course, every language has a different way to describe this. And why string quartet, or this, why string trio? So kind of an homage to this formation, but I didn't want to use string players, or the so-called string players, but percussion players. So this is Ne Percussion. They played this at the Auditorio Nacional in Spain, and right after at my research concert. Okay, so this is exporting processes, and I mean, I'm not intending to do all the pieces like this, but my research was about exploring what resources these applications can offer to composers, and to me, actually, I can use this in other situation. And then these some symbiotic processes, or mixing processes, as I call them, is when you get one instrument and you share this instrument at the same time. So this piece, Violines y Guitarras, has to do with like, though in history there was a point where the vihuela, this old guitar, had three functions. And they were divided in three. So Flacht Vihuela, then it was Bold Vihuela, and then Vihuela de Tanier with a plectrum. So these through split it, and then they developed in their own way. And I say many times, yeah, before this, the musician, the instrumentalist, was meant to do all this at the same time. And I say sometimes for fun, they didn't ask me if this decision was okay for me as a composer. So what I try to do with this piece is to put all this together again. And I will show you a little bit of. So I close this and this, and also make mistakes. So it's in the same Reese's concert. So now there's a guitar player. In this first movement, this piece has five movements. So violin player playing violin, and guitar player playing violin as well. She also plays guitar with a bow. A lot of people told me they need to create with, I mean, not just with instrumental techniques interchange, but in many occasions I heard from the musicians, I need to create new things in my brain for new coordinations. So she was, I mean, I know of at the beginning for her, for Margarete, was kind of challenging, but she did. Fantastic, actually. And then when she had this coordination, she told me, now it's much better, now I can really do all these tasks. So this is one way to hear tremolo, like guitaristic tremolo on the violin. Otherwise, you need a violin player to spend so many years to do this, grow their nails, and I don't know if it's worth it, but this is a way to do this. Not that every piece you can really share one instrument, but if you want, you can do it. No boundaries necessarily. And the guitar player, for example, she claims that doing this piece, that she understands much better what is to bow, actually, because now she has these bowing techniques, because she had to learn for this. I mean, she also played on the electric guitar, and she said, now when I play other things, I really understand the different bowing techniques, and I can really express or use this knowledge when I play guitar. So I have this feeling, I know what is to bow, and I can imitate this in a better way. So there's another piece of these symbiotic processes or mixing processes that I would like to show you. And this one is called Rondo, or Rondo. So in this one, they don't share instruments at the same time, but what is going around, rondo means round, are the instruments. So they are passing around the instruments, and at some point people told me, I didn't know who the viola player was, who the cello player was, because all the instruments were moving around. So, but originally, you don't see, on the back, there's a guitar player, William Anderson, and then the viola player is on this position, on his left. So she is Anne Maria Mo. Moorcroft. She's the first viola player of the German National Orchestra. And then two members of Cygnus Ensemble. So it's violin and cello. And cello, I don't remember the names, but it is there on the... Yeah, Susanna Chapman, yeah. And Margarete as well, yeah. Somebody is moving instruments now. The viola player has a guitar, and I think that the guitar player has now maybe a violin or maybe the viola. So they import. They export mainly their techniques to other instruments. Occasionally the guitar is prepared, like adapted, like a cello. So at the beginning the guitar player is using the guitar mainly as a cello. So this also importing okay, so this is these are some examples of symbiotic processes, rondo, and so how I do these explorations, depending on organological aspects, technical, historical aspects, like what I just said with the vihuela, the three kinds of vihuela, or sometimes because of the choreographic, the motoric movements of I mean, in this case, I'm a guitar player, still a guitar player, you can see, or because how to export or import motorics from one instrument to another one to explore the how they can work. And this one, okay, this piece I composed, it was also a surprise. I didn't know I had to had to do it. So also very challenging to do this piece in a very, very short time. And on this, I also, we were talking about scordatura before, so I was writing here the scordatura, so you can see the scordatura I was using on the guitar. And so I was using different strings to adapt it to this scordatura. And also I have this table that Eleonora made for me. So these are the tables. And then, so kind of 1 year ago, using these instrumental techniques interchange saved my life, or at least, I mean, I'm sure Andrew, he's a nice guy, he wouldn't have killed me, but at least it gave me the opportunity to work a little bit faster and to make something that I would be satisfied with. So this is, unfortunately, because of COVID, we couldn't play together. So we had to do separated by screens because Leonora, she was, she had COVID. So, I mean, she was fine, but she had to be isolated, unfortunately. Mm. So this is me playing two guitars. Not just one, but but two. Okay, so if you want, you can listen to the whole piece, it's online. And so I go back here. So knowing this information, this last information I'm looking for, where am I? This one? This, okay. So now let's imagine what we can do, or what you can really offer. So. As you could see, for composers for next pieces, of course, it's very easy. I'm talking in these examples mainly about guitar instruments and percussion techniques on guitars. So, doing of course importing bowing techniques to the guitar, you can choose your scordatura. That's what I would do. You can do, of course, everyone sees things differently. But what I know that it works very well. So you can use equal strings tuned to 22 if you want. Use more than one instrument and play at the same time. So use as many open strings as possible because the frets on an ordinary guitar, they are semitones. So this is gonna be very challenging for you unless you change the frets. If you don't have the chance to do this, I recommend that you use as many as possible. If you want, you can use this slide under the strings or under two strings on the guitar. So if you want to apply cello techniques, so you can have some notes that might be useful for your ensemble. If you use this open string notes, especially very low strings, so you're gonna have this a lot of resonance, what somebody mentioned before, this ambience, I think it was Gonzalo. So you can do these percussion techniques are very effective, in this case on the guitar, not only. If they have a particular resonance you chose. And you can also create with electric guitars, which I love. You can create guitar installations. I'm sure you saw on the stage, on these pieces I showed, there were four electric guitars hanging. So all of them, they had a special resonance. And in this installation, they were playing one piece and different instrumentalists. So with this, you can create your own installation. It doesn't have to be with hanging guitars. It can be guitars on the table. It can be anything. And with this, you can apply the techniques you might find interesting for your own compositions. And what I mean, all this presentation I did to come to this question for Hans. So you don't have a 22 idiom marimba. so you can make your own one. And so you can use several electric guitars, and then use the tunings in the, I mean, you can create the whole 22 scale, and you can really import percussion marimba techniques to this installation. Okay, I think I finished, so we can have a break. All of you are very, very sleepy, I understand. So, yeah.
Well, it's more like a cimbalo now, how this instrument is.
Yeah, actually, could be. This, Anatavindrija.